I'm Rick LaHusen. I am the project chief of the instrumentation development project at USGS Cascades Volcano Observatory. The work we do developing new systems feeds two basic functions. One is information that we pass to the public emergency managers that can give them early warning on activity, and so they can inform the public and make appropriate action to try to keep people out of harm's way. The second important function for the information we bring back is to understand the volcanic processes. So we feed the research scientists who can understand the volcanoes, how they work, and how they can build to unrest and eruption, or sometimes just go back to sleep. One of the biggest challenges we have is trying to get instruments that can monitor the volcano 24/7 that can survive the hostile conditions up on the mountains. So, for instance, this winter there was 30 feet of snow in many places. That crushing load of snow can block radio signals, it can block sun coming into solar panels. So we have to make instruments that can survive and still get the data out so we can monitor those volcanoes 24/7. Some of the past work at Mount St. Helens relied on people flying out during good weather, landing crews on the ground in harm's way and taking manual measurements of ground movement and gas sampling, things like that. With the new technology, we can actually build a what we call a spider, because it's got many legs on it, but a remote instrument that we can set in place from a cable on a helicopter. It's got an internal battery system. It's got a very smart computer that's been programmed to collect the data from the sensors, lightning, microphones, earthquake sensor, and a GPS unit that can measure motion of the ground less than an inch accurately. It'll send all that data back via a microwave system, and it'll get back to the office within a split second where it can be automatically analyzed continuously. When I first started here, I was deployed down to Colombia following the 1985 eruption of Ruiz volcano. During that eruption, some mud flows were created that killed 23,000 people. And my eyes opened wide to the need for real-time monitoring and efficient communication end-to-end, not just understanding one piece of the puzzle, but having a complete system from sensor through the communication to the public. And everything my team does is always driven towards getting that technology out and employed in a practical basis to give emergency managers the capability to give the public real warning and understanding of what needs to be done and what can be done.